Hello and welcome to Method CRM User Tutorials. My name is Errol and today we are going to tackle databases, tables, and fields. A database holds data. It's a base for data. See, it's in the name. But unlike your closet, a database is a bit more structured. It organizes its data using tables. What's a table? A table stores data about a single topic into rows and columns. Does this structure sound a bit like a spreadsheet? Good, let me use that as an example. Here is a list of customers in a spreadsheet. And let's say I only care about three things about each customer. Their first name, their last name, and their email address. Every row in this list is called a record. If I were to take this customer list of 20 customers and dump it into a table, that table would contain 20 customer records. Now, take a look at this. Every record in our example has three columns of first name, last name, and email address. That doesn't mean that a table can't have more than three columns. No! If I wanted to, I can add more. Favorite color, favorite pet, favorite soup. But for now, I'll keep it at three columns. Anyway, the technical term for these columns, they are called fields. Why call it a field? It's not a force field, so I don't know. This isn't an etymology course. Let's recap our example. Every record you store in our customer table has three fields. Now, of course, you can make more than one table with as many fields as you want. I could make a table to store color, and it has one field, the color. And I can make a pet table, and maybe I'll keep track of the type, vaccination, and color. And all these tables, they will be in one database to rule them all. To tie this back to method, your account is one database, and it's filled with tables that store different information. There's a table for customers and a table for invoices and a lot more tables than I care to list in this tutorial. One last thing I will touch on that may cause some cerebral harm. Tables can access one another. Since they're all in the same database, the data is accessible to all. What does that mean? Let me show you by example in Method CRM. Here I am editing this activity. See these drop-down menus? There's a contact one, an assigned to, a type, and a status. All of these are fields within an activity. So there is a table, probably called activity, and it has these fields. In reality, it's a bit more complicated than this, but just work with me here. But the best part? The values of these fields are taken from other tables. So within the activity table, there is a contact field and it points to the contacts table. The assigned to field points to a users table, and there's also a type table and a status table as well. It's so interconnected and complicated and a bit confusing. But that's why we use computers for other things than sharing your first world problems on social media. Anyway, this just touches the surface of tables and fields in Method CRM. When you go through our tutorials, we talk about tables and fields an awful lot. So I sure hope you've grasped this. The concepts of tables and fields are part of database terminology. So use Google to find more information on the theory behind databases. Don't give me that. I find it interesting. Anyway, if you have any questions, leave a comment on YouTube, check out our documentation, post on our forums, or you can tweet us at Method CRM. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.